Hi there, and welcome back to Floss Marketing School. In this video, I'm going to talk about SEO Panel and how you can install it. So SEO Panel, as its name stands for it, is a software about search engine optimization. And what is great with this software is that it's released under the GNU GPL license version 2. So that's interesting because it means that you can hack it and do whatever you want with it. And that's interesting as well because within, let's say, the SEO community, you do not have that much free software or open source projects, so that's always interesting to know that it exists and try to use it. So in my case, I'm no expert with it. I just learned about it some months ago, and I just wanted to install it for the first time today, so as I did. So as you can see here, I installed it locally, and this is SEO Panel, and I can play with all the different tools for free, because it's self-hosted, and I can see what it has in its guest. In this video, I'm just going to focus on how to install it. So this is what I did. So I went on seopanel.org/download and I downloaded it. Just to let you know, it's very easy to install. I mean, easy is a big word when you talk with server software, but just to let you know that it's as easy as installing a WordPress or anything like this. So once you have it downloaded, then you move it to your local server, which will probably be within the following folder. Then you unzip it. They have done the zip file quite well, so it means that when you unzip it, it's going to create a folder which is named SEO Panel, so you don't need to create one. And then you can start to access within your browser to the following URL, localhost slash SEO panel. Then it's going to tell you, okay, but I need to get some rights in order to write to the database. So you just, I need some rights just, so you just need to execute this given line of code in order to give the following rights, and then you need as well to perform this one in order to give right to right within the temporary folder. Then what they're going to ask you next is to which database you want to connect it to. So here I imagine that you already have a MySQL server running. So if so, you run sudo MySQL in order to enter within MySQL, then you create a database that you name as you wish. In my case, I named it SEO Panel. Then you give the privileges to this given database to the user that you have within your database, and then you exit MySQL. Once done, you enter those credentials within the localhost slash SEO panel slash install page. And then once you have done so, they will tell you that everything has been installed. After they're asking you to change the permission and to remove the installation file, just do those two actions. Once you can see the dashboard of SEO Panel. If not, you will not be able to proceed. And when you see the dashboard, then you just perform sudo rm install, and then you remove you change the right permission, and that's it. Then you can get an access to the SEO Panel dashboard and play with the different features and see how it's going. Thanks for watching.